Mark Farber, Professor of Surgery, Chief of the Division of Vascular Surgery, Director of the UNC Aortic Network. A vascular surgeon is a specialist who treats a patient with disorders that involve arteries and veins. We deal with all the vessels in the body except generally the heart vessels and the ones that lead to the brain once they enter the brain. The vascular surgeon, which traditionally meant doing surgical procedures only, where you actually operate on patients, but vascular surgery is no longer that discipline. It's not been that way for over two decades. So in the past two decades, a vascular surgeon does minimally invasive or endovascular procedures as well as traditional open surgical procedures. And they are trained in all of the medical management of patients with vascular disorders. Vascular surgery, our patients have long-standing issues, and so we offer all the breadth of care of patients with vascular disorders, medical treatment, surgical options, and endovascular options. Most of the research done in vascular surgery is based on clinical outcomes and advancing the care of patients with vascular problems. And that involves assessing and improving devices and stents that are used to treat those disorders. In the area that I work in, aortic disease, we've been at it now for just about two decades of advancing aortic devices for treating aneurysmal disease and dissections. And that has come from an era when we did nothing now to where 90% of what we can do for all aortic treatments can be minimally invasive. It requires experience of these devices, and the devices have little nuances about issues we recognize are a problem, how to advance those issues and improve the care of patients. And that's really where we've been advancing a lot of our work, is on the device side of things. We always are looking at outcomes of patients, either endovascular or open, to try to continue to improve the results and try to select our patients so they get the best procedure and the best outcome, not only in the short term, but in the long term. One of about eight sites in the United States that have access to advanced custom manufactured devices to treat complex aortic problems. That provides patients with potential options that aren't available at most other institutions in the United States. I think patients should realize this: when you come to a major medical center, it's not always about one person. It's about the whole system that's been designed. It's the entire team that takes care of the patient. From the nurse that sees it when they check into clinic, to the front desk personnel, to the operating room nurses and the anesthesiologist and the ICU team and the clerk on the floor, to the person that discharges them. It's the whole process. It's not just one individual, and that's what makes UNC unique, is that our approach is a team approach. It's not about one person. UNC has a tradition of advanced vascular care for several decades, and so I wanted to make sure I continued to work at an institution that's provide state-of-the-art care for many decades. The division has moved to a subspecialization approach, and that we're large enough now that with the number of individuals we have, that we can provide expert care in aortic disease, expert care in carotid disease, expert care in thoracic outlet syndrome, and some of these subspecializations that a smaller group is difficult in providing expertise in all areas. Not all of us do aortic work, not all of us do thoracic outlet work, but we have enough individuals in each area that when a patient arrives here, either electively or urgently or emergently, we can provide expert care in all those areas and take care of the patient efficiently to get the best outcomes possible.